Hey guys, it's Retired at 40 here. Today I'm going to build a hoop house to extend our growing season a little bit. It's cooling off here in the Rockies. And we're going to try and do it for just under $200. And if you check the description below, you can see a list of materials you'll need. And you can come along for the ride. Today we are making a 10x10 hoop house or high tunnel on a budget. Trying to keep it around $200. It's a beautiful day in Colorado, but I know better. It'll be fall before we know it, and we kind of want to extend our growing season. And our goal is to fit two of these guys, which are 3x8 raised beds inside of this 10x10 hoop house. And then we'll actually put another small hoop house on top of it with a hinge. And I'll show you how to do that in a different video. But if you check the description below, we'll actually have all of the pricing of what I spent on this hoop house, and then all of your dimensions and what you'll need to build it. All right, the first thing you need is 4 2x6x10 pieces of lumber. Two of them will need to be cut to 120 inches or 10 feet. Most of the time when you buy them at a lumber store, they're a little bit longer than 10 feet. So cut them down to 10 feet. I'm doing mine in my whole hoop house in 10x10. So you can adjust your measurements as needed. And to cut it to 120 inches and then to cut at 117 inches. And that way, when you put them together, this side will be 10 feet. Next thing you'll need is a box of galvanized or deck screws, 1¼ inches, and that'll be to hold these little grommets that will hold your hoops this way. And then you will need 22 of these guys. And those will just kind of stabilize your hoops. And I went every 2 feet with mine. And then do the same. On the other side. Now my hoop house is not perfectly level because I do want it to drain. And I will actually fill in part of the inside just for protection from the cold and wind and whatnot when it does start cooling off more. Next thing you will need is these 10-foot sections of 3/4 inch PVC. And then you will put them together with PVC cement or all-purpose cement. Just like that, so you have a 20-foot section. And the 20-foot section allows it to be long enough that you can stand up in the actual hoop, which was one of my main requirements when I was building it. And you will need 12 pieces of the 10-foot PVC. And when you buy the PVC, make sure you get the, there's two different kinds. This is schedule 40, but there is a difference between sections of walls. Let's see if I can get a close up here. This one is the thicker one. It's only about 10 or 20 cents more per stick, but it'll be a lot more rigid when it's done. And that should be everything we need for this first part. All right, once you got everything screwed or nailed together on the frame, then set all of your conduit grommets at 2 feet apart. And then once you get those set in there, then you can actually put your hoop pieces in. And then just take a drill, go right through the center like that. Throw a screw in there, just to keep it in place. All right, next we're gonna do the supports and then followed by the door after that. So for the supports, you need some 2x4x10s. I use treated lumber because this is gonna be outside for a lot of time. And it's not actually touching the soil, so it'll withstand the test of time a lot better. So mark them at 10 feet. Like I said earlier, they tend to not be 10 feet. They're usually a little longer. You can see where I marked 10 feet on those. And then we're actually gonna be cutting these in half. So I mark them at 1¾ inches, which would be half of the 3.5 inches that they are wide. And then I use a skill saw, which is not for everyone, to cut them in half. You can use a table saw as well. And then once you get those ripped in half, you're gonna take another piece of 3/4 inch PVC. And I like to mark, we're gonna cut them to 2 inches. I like to actually mark them on the table, and then you kind of have an idea of where you can do the next one. And then once we have our 2 inch pieces, I'm gonna cut this little section out here. And then I went ahead and I marked out my increments every 2 feet, just like you did with the bottom part of the frame where the actual hoops are sitting. And then we also have 24 of these little slip joints that we're actually going to make some more of later, because they come in real handy. Just being able to slip over the other pieces of PVC on the hoop. So what we need to do is take a drill and then through here. Grab the screw. Do that every 2 feet on every single one of these pieces, and I'll catch you in a second. All right, once you got these all screwed into here, you should have 4 of those. I've actually already put one on here. The great thing about the slip joints is they can be adjusted once they're in place. So you can push them up, push them down. You want to hang certain things on there or adjust them or whatever. Next we're going to do the door, and I'm actually going to put mine, the width of the door, on the top here, and you'll see why once we get everything squared away. All right, making the door and the frame. So you might need to adjust your door height or width depending on your preference. I want mine to be 36 inches wide, and because my hoop house might be a little bit different size than yours will be, I'm gonna make my door 74 inches tall. So this piece here and this piece here are 74 inches, and then this piece here and on the top and this one in the middle, they are 33 inches. And then just to make it look a little nicer and give it a little bit more rigidity, these little cross supports here are 8 inches from long to long. And I think it makes look a little nicer, and I think that it'll help not to warp in the future since it's gonna be outside. And then on the frame, I built the frame 1/2 inch bigger on each side, and that will just account for just a little bit of fluff room, I guess, if it does warp or hangs funny or it needs adjustment in the future. So the outside pieces here are 78 inches. Top, bottom, those are 37. So, when you fit it inside, got a little playroom for it to fit in. And I'm actually making two doors, one on each side of the hoop house, front and back. So I'm going to be doing this twice. If you just want one door, obviously just do it once. Got the door frame sitting in there. So go ahead and mark your 10-foot piece here. Mark that, mark the center of that, which would be 5 feet. And then mark the center of your door frame, which in this case is 18 and a half from inside to inside. Mark the center of that, line those up, and then do the same on the top, mark the center. It should be relatively close to the center of the hoop there. And then when you have those lined up, square them up, drill a hole, put in a screw, just to tack it there. And then we're gonna try and square up the top as well. And then you'll connect your cross supports with the top of the door here. All right, got the frame in, got the top attached, and you have to move your cross supports accordingly so they're evenly spaced up there, and then just attach them to the top of that door frame. So next, we want to attach these side supports. So I cut two more pieces. In my case, it was 33 inches on each side here, to here to here. So I'm gonna put those in, and then we're gonna work on putting the door in. All right, look at that. Cross supports are in, door frame's in. Everything's looking sturdy. It's time to put some hinges on the door and get this puppy hung. Well, it looks like everything's coming along real nice. Come and join us on part two, and we'll get the doors in place and put the finishing touches on this thing.